Hi, I'm Henry Segerman. This is a genus 2 surface. The word genus refers to how many holes the surface has. So 2 holes, that's why it's called a genus 2 surface. The genus 1 surface with 1 hole is usually called a torus, and the genus 0 surface is the sphere. You've maybe seen this sphere on my channel before. This is for illustrating holonomy. Holonomy is the effects you get when you travel around a loop like this. You come back, rotate it, even though on each leg of the path there's no rotations. At the start, the arms point to the right and down, and then when I move it around, they now point to the right and up. We've been rotated. In fact, we get rotated the same direction that we move. If we go around the triangle clockwise, then the arms get rotated clockwise. If we go around anticlockwise, then the arms get rotated anticlockwise. We call a piece a rook because it travels like a rook in chess. You move along straight lines, and then you can change direction by 90 degrees. If we do the same thing on an actual flat chessboard, it doesn't matter how we move, we don't get rotated, so there's no holonomy here. Okay, now what about this genus 2 surface? Again, we have these paths. Again, we have a rook that can move in straight lines and can change direction by 90 degrees. The difference is the shape. The sphere had right-angled triangles, the chessboard had right-angled squares. This thing, well, what are these shapes here? They've got right angles, but how many corners? There's one here, 2, 3, 4, 5, and we're back to the start. So this is a right-angled pentagon. Okay, so before I do it, pause the video and comment below. What do you think? Does the genus 2 surface have holonomy? That is, if I move this rook around the boundary of this right angle pentagon, will it have rotated when it gets back? And if it does rotate, in which direction? All right, let's see. The arms start pointing to the right and down. And now I'm going to move the rook around the pentagon in a counterclockwise direction. And when I get back to the start, the arms are now pointing to the left and down. So they started off to the right and down, so that means that it rotated in the clockwise direction, even though we went around the pentagon in the counterclockwise direction. If you go around clockwise, then it gets rotated counterclockwise and vice versa. So it's the opposite from what we had on the sphere. This is to do with the sphere having positive curvature, while a genus 2 surface has negative curvature. I put in an exit for the rook that only lets it out when it's in the correct orientation, just like for the sphere. So I could also put pegs along the paths and make a genus 2 holonomy maze. But I haven't got around to that yet. For the spherical designs, you can encode positions and orientations of the rook and the pegs and so on using quaternions. That won't work here, so getting the code working to search for good mazes would be more complicated. I printed the gray and black pentagonal panels separately on a desktop printer rather than the usual selective laser sintering. The panels don't do anything mechanically, but they make it much easier to see the surface. They bend and snap into the frame made by the rails. All right, that's it. Thanks for watching.